Good morning, students. Today we will study about microorganisms. Before I start, I want to ask you a question, that what happens when you do not eat lunch at school and forget to take out your lunch box from your bag after reaching home? The next morning, the food in the lunch box smells foul and you see a white coating grown all over it. Why this happens? Dear students, this is nothing but growth of microorganisms called fungi all over the food. Microorganisms are the tiny organisms which cannot be seen with a naked eye. They can be seen only with the help of a microscope. Microorganisms are present everywhere. They can be found on a moist piece of bread, spoiled food, decaying flour, in air, in water, in different conditions, be it hot or cold. The study of microorganisms is called microbiology, and the people who study microorganisms are known as microbiologists. Microorganisms are divided into five major categories, and these are bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, and viruses. Today we will study them one by one. So, the first category is bacteria. Bacteria are the smallest, oldest, and simplest unicellular organisms on our planet. They are mostly single-celled, but can live in groups called colonies. They are found everywhere, such as air, water, and even in our food. Some bacteria are very useful, like lactobacillus, which we all know, it helps in the formation of curd from milk. Another useful bacteria is rhizobium. It fixes the atmospheric nitrogen into soil, which is very useful for the growth of plants. Some bacteria are harmful also. They cause diseases in plants, animals, and human beings. Bacteria are found in different shapes, such as rod shape, spherical shape, spiral shape, and coma shape. Now, the next category of microorganisms is algae. Dear students, you must have seen some green patchy-like structure in moist places or in stagnant water. These green-colored structures are algae. These are plant-like organisms. Now, why they are called plant-like organisms? Because they have a cell wall as well as the green pigment chlorophyll. Due to the presence of this green chlorophyll, they can prepare their own food by photosynthesis process. Some algae have different color pigments like red, brown, blue. That is why they are categorized as green algae, blue algae, red algae, and blue-green algae. Some examples of algae are Spirogyra, seaweeds, Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Chlorella, and Diatoms. Seaweeds are edible. Now we will discuss another category of microorganisms, and that is fungi. Fungi are organisms which share a common feature with plants, and that is a cell wall. They have a cell wall but do not have chlorophyll. That is why they are called non-green plants. Since they do not have chlorophyll, they cannot prepare their food. They absorbs food from other plants, dead animals, or stale food. They are mostly found in warm and moist places. They spoil our food, clothes, and leather. Some fungi are edible, like mushroom. Now the next category of microorganism is protozoa. Protozoa are the microorganisms that have animal-like characteristics. They can move from one place to another and can hunt their food. They are mostly aquatic, means they live in water, but can also be found in soil and in bodies of other organisms. The protozoa that live in the bodies of other organisms are called parasites. And parasites means the organisms that derive their food from the host without benefiting them. Some common examples of protozoa are amoeba, paramecium, trypanosoma, and plasmodium. Now the next category of microorganisms is viruses. The name virus is derived from a Latin word which means poison. Viruses are the smallest microorganisms. They are so small that they cannot be seen even through an ordinary compound microscope. We need an electron microscope to view them. Viruses are considered on the borderline of living and non-living things. Means they are in between living and non-living organisms. But why is it so? This is because viruses do not have any cellular structure of their own. They remain in an inactive state when outside the host body. It means they are not capable of growing, moving, or reproducing on their own. However, as soon as they enter a living organism, they become active and get the energy of the host cells to divide themselves, grow rapidly, and reproduce inside the body of the living organisms and cause diseases. In this way, they infect the host cells and cause various diseases. Some examples of viruses are bacteriophage, HIV, coronavirus, which is causing COVID-19 disease nowadays. Thank you.